Hello, thank you for being here. And first of all, I would like to thank the organizing team of this great, I would say, orchestrated conference. And I think the first of this size in the field of research in art under the sign of Deleuze and Guattari thought. And I warmly salute such an initiative. Deleuze and Guattari invite us to creative processes which modify relation, hierarchies, categories. My intention is not to apply any philosophical concept in music, but as Deleuze underlined it, some tasks are similar between art and philosophy. Common matter resonates in research and in music and increase a process based on experimentation. It's the case, for instance, with the role of variables, process and diagrammatic patterns, going with the idea of consistency. Since many years, since the beginning of the 80s, in fact, 1980s, I am mainly interested in sound variability and dynamic variables of acoustic process. I am particularly interested in these micrologic aspects, which are questioning our perception and brain. I often use scordatura, modifying the tuning of instruments such as piano, violin, cello, guitars, tuned according to regular, irregular, or variable temperaments. It's okay now. It was all over the. Moreover, not to be too abstract, as I talk about microtunings, I want to show you and to make you hear, for instance, what can be done with a guitar tuning 1/16 of a tune, sorry. C'est très petit. The sound is not coming up. You have sound there? What Deleuze meant by building a plane of consistency. Deleuze paid particular attention to ways of contracting relations and creating a floating state, gathering independent lines, constituting a restless nebula agitated with local contraction, minute tension, and then these autonomized, extracted, displaced operation. Far from a fixed frame, various levels of attention mark the process of thought, which from my point of view is not far from familiar movement in music composition. As our time is counted, I will go straight into the production of differences and individuation underlying consistency, which matter for music. During a lecture at the Sorbonne in 1967, Deleuze outlines the sub-representative dynamics principle of reciprocity, determining the individuating intensive experience in a complementary double movement of both organization and qualifying qualities and surfaces, species, species, espèce, species, and parts, party. The intensive model of the egg is given in reference as a pure specimen, not yet extensive, prior to organism extension or body's organization, that differential forces will integrate by engaging in divergent ways, dividing lines of differentiation, without which all would remain in the dispersion of an unrealized pose. This is maybe very abstract, but for the music, it corresponds to the fact that we can imagine we are in front of the multiplicity of variables of the sound, which is a physical reality. But on the other side, if we have to extract individuation, we have to be away from pre-hierarchized relation, such as, for instance, consonancy, which has been a system very productive, but today probably we have also different things to differentiate. So, difference is an operator of Deleuze and Guattari's thought, and far from a given state, it is an emergent and productive operation. So, a few words about this complexity, considering sound, whether it's produced by instruments, bodies, machines, or natural elements. We are confronted in the interrelation of many components and variables crossing each other. Sound analysis and sound synthesis modeling learned us how sound is complex. Sound has no materiality in itself. It's an ensemble of constraint and determination in constant evolution, a complex and dynamic multiplicity. So the acoustic multiplicity, as I would propose it here, includes all the factors that shape the sound and the potentiality of spatial and temporal variables that may specify in a particular sound event. I consider that composing with variables within the acoustic multiplicity includes then spatial and temporal data in the entire chain of determination that handle the production of the sound signal. From the initial condition of emission of sound to energy system that maintains it, from its projection, diffusion and propagation to its reception in an acoustic space. Here is the interest of this spatium, of an abstract and empty plan of composition, which could be said a non-composition plan. As Deleuze mentioned it, consistency and composition play is somehow empty. It's a non-composition play, degree zero. For now, I will focus on microvariability, laying on microinterval existence and gesture process. Microtuning takes their whole meaning as stirring up sound sensibility, modifying the relation between timbre and pitch, reinventing ways of producing sound, and instrumental techniques, and then generating unheard differences. The instrumental point of view is very important for me, and I work in close collaboration with musicians to adapt tuning possibilities with way of playing, expression, notation. And I consider microtunings and extended techniques as access towards acoustic variability of sound. Microintervalic systems bring out the possibility to modify sound, to organize it under the identity of the note. It allows modulation, differences of frequencies that favorize transitiveness and microacoustic emergency, bringing out new expression. Moving toward the field of sound determination allows to compose, to decompose, to recompose sounds, components, relation in order to shape sound events and new spatial and temporal connection. I would say that different level participates, a distributive level organization, what Yanis Xenakis would call orto, a physical one with all the sound properties that are mainly analyzed, and an intensive level, crossing materiality, crossing techniques and subjectivities. These three levels are intervening all the time. I would say that they must be taken together. Let's see how to experiment this instrument. I wanted to tell you about when I say that this tuning may catch unheard or different properties than notes. I mean, it's a cross between movement and what the near the proximity of frequencies can bring as different acoustic behavior. For instance, I will talk about behavior here is, as you will see, Deborah playing, there is a movement which is sliding, and you can hear both parts of the string instead of playing only on one part that is controlled. Here we try to control something else, which is acoustic behavior. So it changes the idea of which gesture, what form. The complementary modes goes in a different direction, and one is regular, following the fingerings, and the other one is logarithmic and non-transparent. So it brings the necessity to notate rather gesture than notes. Here you hear. I think we are at the end of the. Right? Je mets mon concert sur la droite. Là, c'est le début. More recently, I go further in this idea of gesture and coming rather to the fact that gestures are realizing something else than an expected metric or a tempered fact, but rather to be in the process of reaching acoustic and transformation value. So it brings me to work very collaborate with an instrumentist and in order to on these instruments which are so detuned, so transformed that you cannot play anything on it. It's just the degree zero of instrument. For instance, circuit process for a violin, sorry, tuned also in 16th of a tone, which is built, this is just an esquisse, which is built on 12 states that are progressively transformed, and the instrument is the player takes the time that she wants for doing it. Chaos Catcher that I have co-signed with Deborah is also a process. It's a shift process, so it's not a continuous transitivity that is expected, but this is the middle of the axis given by this tuning, the middle, the harmonic middle, the fingerings, possible fingerings, and sorry, this is in French. So Chaos Catcher is exploring the sonority of Scordatura, and the route is setted following a map of five sequences. Pardon, parlando, polyphonie, polyphonie. This is a way to keep in mind all the memorized kinesthetic mapping that have been memorized with during a big research, because starting with zero has to orient it, to select, to analyze, and to fix, and this is quite a travel. Priority is given to dynamic expression, to consistency, time, and process, to the development of listening in duration with embodied gesture and dynamic imagination. Time is floating, adjustable. Time is related to variable and degrees of uncertainty. It's not metric, but there is time, and this is always the same. Gesture is not submitted to a fixed result. Gesture is above all productive, elaborated within expression of the event consistency itself. Okay. I start at D7 at 20, so if it's half an hour, it goes to well, I don't know.
Yeah, but that's the way it is, and I'm sorry, you're cutting off people all the time.
It's not my pleasure, I also compose, yeah, it's like not, I'm sharing.
Well, I have half an hour, I need that,
yes,
as you know.
Yeah,
okay, and time usually limited in written music interpretation is here valued to carry a kinesthetic idea. In the case of the right time, might be quite different of the exact time.
No,
So let's hear, let's hear some of these plays that are characterized in Cal Spectra. For instance, maybe you present it to the one, because I'm not going to present the one you played.
First of all, the tuning, which is in 16th per tone. Then the research is a kind of topographic, so it's really the sounds come from different parts of the instrument. And there's a parlando.
Which is recently edited on Gilles Deleuze.